Hey guys, welcome to Initiate Science here, where science meets you. In today's video, let's discuss the question answers for the lesson A Hero by R.K. Narayan.
Good morning, children. This is the notes for Chapter 1, A Hero by R.K. Narayan for 10th Standard State Pattern Textbook. Swami's father drew his attention to a report in the newspaper. What was the report? The answer is, the newspaper report was about a brave village lad who fought with a tiger. He stayed on a tree until some people came to his rescue. The second question, the report said that the boy who fought with the tiger stayed on the tree for half a day. Why did he do so? Choose the right answer. A. He wanted to watch the tiger from the top of a tree. B. He wanted someone to kill the tiger. C. He wanted to take rest for some time. The answer is option B. He wanted someone to kill the tiger. What do you think was the practice of Granny before she went to bed? Swami's Granny used to narrate to him a story before they went to bed. Second question, was Swami really sleeping or was he pretending? The answer is, Swami was not really sleeping but was pretending to be asleep so that his father would not disturb him. Third question, Swami said that a very strong and grown-up person might have fought with the tiger. Do you think he made this remark out of his option A, experience, option B, wisdom, option C, belief? Choose the most appropriate word. The answer is C, belief. Fourth question, can you prove you have courage? Swami's father said, answer the following questions. Was he joking? Was he joking or serious? B, was it challenging or a command? The answer is A, he was serious. This we can easily summarize from the insistence on Swami sleeping alone in the office room. B, it was both a challenge and a command. He challenged Swami to prove that he had courage, as his stand was that even if one is small and doesn't have the strengths of a grown-up, if one has courage, one can defeat his adversary. Opponent, it was a command also, as he would not accept a no for an answer from Swami. Fifth question, the place where Swami usually slept was, fill in the blank. Answer is, beside his granny. Sixth question, what is disgraceful? According to Swami's father, the answer is, according to Swami's father, though his son was grown up and in the second form, still he was sleeping beside his granny like a baby. Third question, to Swami, his father looked like an dash, fill in the blank, apparition. Why do you think Swami looked at his granny and his mother while following his father to the room? Answer, Swami looked at his granny and his mother because he hoped that they would come to his rescue and ask his father not to compel Swami to sleep in the office room. The fifth question, there might be scorpions behind your law books, said Swami. A. Had he seen them earlier or were there scorpions really? B. Question, was it a trick to escape from his father? Answer all the questions. The answer for A is, Swami might or might not have seen scorpions. From the story, we cannot make out whether he had actually seen scorpions. However, since he uses the word might be while referring to scorpions behind the law books, we can conclude that he was just using scorpions as an excuse not to sleep in the office room. B. The answer is yes, absolutely, it was a trick to escape from his father. Swami wished that The tiger hadn't spared the boy, which means dash. Choose the right answer. A. He didn't want the boy to be alive. B. He didn't want the tiger to be alive. The answer is A. He didn't want the boy to be alive. Second question. As silence deepened in the room, what was Swami reminded of? Answer. As silence deepened in the room, Swami was reminded of all the stories of devils and ghosts he had heard from his Chummani and the story about Muniswami's father and his fourth class friend who had been carried off by a ghost. Third question. Which place in the room did Swami think was safe, compact and reassuring? The answer is Swami thought that it would be safe, compact and reassuring under the bench. Fourth question. Swami touched Dash in the room instead of Granny. Fill in the blanks appropriately. The answer is the wooden leg of the bench. Swami touched the wooden leg of the bench in the room instead of Granny. Fifth question. Swami saw a moving creature in the room. It was Dash. Fill in the blank. A. His shadow. B. A scorpion. C. A man. The answer is C. A man. First question. Who cried, "Ayyo, something has bitten me"? Answer is the burglar cried, "Ayyo, something has bitten me." Second question. Who did father, cook and a servant stumble upon? The answer is father, cook and a servant stumbled upon the burglar who lay amidst the furniture. Third question. Why were congratulations showered on Swami? The answer is congratulations were showered on Swami because unknowingly he helped to catch the most notorious housebreakers of the district. Fourth question. Do you think that Swami really wanted to join the police? If not, what did he want to be? The answer is no. Swami was not interested to join the police. He wanted to become an engine driver, railway guard or a bus conductor. Fifth question. Did Swami muster up courage to sleep alone after the burglar's incident? Answer. No. Swami did not have so much courage to sleep even after the burglar's incident. Sixth question. Who supported Swami? His mother or his granny? The answer is his mother supported him. First question. A report about a boy in the newspaper was an unexpected event in Swami's life. Justify. Answer. If his father hadn't read about the bravery of the village boy, he wouldn't have started comparing Swami with him. He wouldn't have challenged Swami to show his bravery. It is unfortunate for Swami that such a rare incident takes place and gets reported in the newspaper and catches the attention of Swami's father. Yes, indeed, the report about the boy in the newspaper was an unexpected event in Swami's life. Second question. Swami made a comment on the newspaper report. Was he right? How did his view differ from that of his father? The answer is Swami made a comment on the newspaper report. No. He was not right. But according to his belief, to face a tiger and fight with it means definitely he should be grown up. Swami's strength and age are important to fight, but Swami's father's view was different. To support his view, he gave an example such as a man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward if he doesn't fight at all, whereas another may have the strength of the straw, but if he has courage, he can do anything. Courage is everything. Strength and age are not important. Third question. What desperate attempts did Swami make to escape from his father? The answer is, When Swami's father challenged him to sleep alone, Swami hoped that he was only joking. He mumbled yes weakly and tried to change the topic by speaking to his father about the new bats and balls and the decision of his cricket club to admit even elders when his father kept to his decisions. He tried to postpone the date by promising to sleep alone from the first of the coming month. Next, he pretended to have fallen asleep next to his granny with the blanket covering his face. But when his father pulled the blanket away and ordered him to sleep alone, as the last request, he pleaded with his father to allow him to sleep in the hall instead of the office room. But all these attempts turned out to be futile, as his father remained resolute in his decision. Fourth question. Why did Swami conclude that his father's proposition was frightful? Swami had a habit of sleeping beside his granny. He was afraid of sleeping alone. In this condition, Swami concluded that his father's proposition or suggestion was frightful. Fifth question. As the night advanced, Swami felt that something terrible would happen to him. What would it be? How would it happen? Answer is, when he was in the office room at night, he remembered all the devil and ghost stories. His friend Mani had seen the devil in the banyan tree. Muniswami's father spat out blood, his thoughts linked like a chain. Swami thought that something terrible would happen to him. The ghost may come and carry him away. All these thoughts made him faint. Sixth question. There was absolute silence in the room. In spite of it, some noises reached Swami's ears. What were they? The answer is, the different kinds of noises reached Swami's ears, added to his fear. In the stillness of the night, even usual sounds added to Swami's nervousness. The tickling of the clock, the rustle of the trees, snoring sounds and the humming sound of the night were the different sounds that reached Swami's ears in the stillness of the night. Narrate Swami's dreadful experience when he was lying under the bench. Though Swami fell asleep when he slept under the bench, he was troubled by nightmares. He dreamt of a tiger chasing him and his inability to escape as his feet were stuck to the ground and wouldn't move. The tiger was at his back and he could hear the claws scratching the ground. There was also a loud thud. Swami desperately tried to open his eyes but couldn't. Finally, when he opened his eyes, he realized that he wasn't next to his granny. In this wakeful state, he was in for another horror. He could sense something moving down, and he thought it was the devil that had come to take him. In his desperation, he hugged it with all his strength and bit into it. Once again. Eighth question. How was Swami honored by his classmates, teachers and the headmasters? The answer is, Swami became a hero in one night. The next day morning, congratulations were showered on him. His classmates looked at him with great respect. His teachers patted his back and felt very proud of him. The headmaster praised him as he was a real scout. Even the police were grateful to him for it. Ninth question. Why did the father want Swami to sleep alone in the office room? The answer is, father wanted Swami to sleep alone in the office room to prove courage is everything. According to Swami, age and strength were most important in adventurous tasks. But in Swami's father's view, the strength and age were not so important. Courage is all. To prove Swami had also courage, he should sleep alone in the office room. 10th. Who do you think was wiser, Swami or his father? justify your preference. According to the prose, Swami was wiser. Swami was afraid of darkness and loneliness. When he saw something was moving, he felt that his end had come. He assumed that the devil would pull him and tear him. So why should he wait as it came nearer? He crawled out from the bench, hugged it, and used his tooth like a mortal weapon. This shows at the time of emergency, he used his wisdom. By this act, he helped to catch the notorious burglar. So we can justify that Swami was wiser. 11th question. Why did Swami feel relieved at the end? The answer is, when their father returned home from the club that night, he asked his wife about Swami. Swami, as usually, slept behind his granny. Father thought that Swami slept before he could return home to avoid him. So he said that he was very clever. For that, mother lost her temper and supported Swami and said that he can sleep wherever he likes. There is no need to take risk to his life again. Father mumbled that if Swami was spoiled, there is no blame on his side. By hearing this conversation, Swami felt relieved at the end. 12th question. Suppose you are the Swami of the story. Write a brief letter to your friend describing how you would have helped to catch a burglar in your house. Malgudi, 17th May 21, from Swami, 2nd form, Malgudi, to Ravi, 2nd cross, Indiranagar, Bangalore 8. My dear Ravi, how are you? I am fine, and my parents too are fine. My granny inquires about you often. How is your school and friends? I hope you are also fine there. Last week, my dad ordered me to sleep in his office room alone. You know that till today I sleep beside my granny. I was afraid very much, but I had to obey my dad. I slept alone in his office room. When I was asleep, I heard a sound. I got up and saw that there was something moving towards me. I hugged it and bit with all my strength. There was a cry. By hearing the cry, my dad, servant, and other family members came and caught the person. To our surprise, he was a notorious burglar. Like this, I helped to catch the burglar, though it was not my intention. I was expecting your early reply. Convey my regards to your family members. Yours, loving friend, Swami. 13th question. Some words describing the characters of the story, a hero, are given in the brackets. Put them in those columns appropriately. In these columns appropriately. Caring, protective, innocent, tricky, authoritative, disciplined, helpless, nervous. Swami's father, mother, granny, and Swami. The answer is Swami's father, disciplined, authoritative, mother, caring, protective, granny, innocent, Swami, tricky, helpless, and nervous. Enrich your vocabulary. Task 1. Homophones. Homophones are words that sound the same but have different meanings and different spellings. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words. First one, we had dash many apples to carry. Two, T-O-O and T-W-O. The answer is T-O-O, two. We had too many apples to carry. I dash a horse at the Marina Beach. R-O-A-D, R-O-D-A. The answer is R-O-D-A. I rode a horse at the Marina Beach. Third question. Did you have a dash for lunch? Pear. P-E-A-R and pear. P-A-I-R. The answer is pear. P-E-A-R. Did you have a pear for lunch? Fourth one. The books are over dash on the shelf. T-H-E-I-R. There. comma THERE. The answer is THERE. The books are over there on the shelf. Task 2. Fill in the blanks by choosing the appropriate word and complete the story. This is a dash, story, story told by a knight, knight. Once he received a letter. When he, READ, read it through, THROUGH, he would not believe his own eyes. FOR, it was written by BY, none other than the queen of the land. She asked him to meet her at a secret place. The knight was in a fire, but he thought OF of a plan to tide over this problem. He went, WENT, to the meeting place, not alone, but along with his fair, FAIR, wife. Can you guess what happened then? Task 3. Scramble the letters to form words. See the meaning clues in the brackets. ATRTEFL. Praise. Flatter. The answer is FLATTER. Flatter. BOUDT. Suspect. Answer is doubt. DOUBT. Third one. RAGTEDY. Unhappy ending. The answer is tragedy. TRAGEDY. Fourth one. RAGFEMNT. A piece. The answer is fragment. FRAGMENT. Fifth question. RAETL. Careful. Answer is alert. ALERT. Sixth one. CACSRIYT. Short supply. The answer is scarcity. SCARCITY. Seventh one. YMTSATHPEIC. Not cruel. The answer is sympathetic. SYMPATHEDIC. Sympathetic. Listen and comprehend. I once took part in a drama. I wanted to tell my co-actor, stars were twinkling, dogs were barking, dogs were twinkling, and the thief broke the clock and took away the wall. The audience had a great laugh. That day onwards, I decided not to go on stage. Answer the following. Why do you think the audience on hearing the dialogue burst into laughter? The answer is the audience burst into laughter because the actor said the dialogue in the wrong way. It was like a joke, so they burst into laughter. Second question. Try to repeat the words as delivered by the actor. Answer. Do it practically for the students. Third question. If you've been the actor, how would you have said it? If I had been the actor, I would have practiced correctly and delivered the dialogue effectively. Read and respond. Task 1. A man went to an astrologer. The astrologer said, "Come, my child, your name is Suraj Khanna." "Khanna." "Yes, indeed, astrologer. You have two sons and two daughters, Khanna." "How true, astrologer. You bought 4 kilos of sugar and 5 kilos of rice yesterday, and there are 5 members of your household remaining after your parents passed away." "Khanna." "I am impressed, but can you tell about my future?" "Astrologer." "Okay then, come back with your horoscope booklet tomorrow, and here, take your ration card back." Answer the following. Mr. Khanna was surprised at the astrologer's prediction. What made him feel so? The answer is, when Mr. Khanna went to an astrologer, the astrologer said the truth without asking any questions. All statements were true, so he was very much impressed and felt surprised. But Mr. Khanna didn't know that all the details were in his ration card, not by the predictions of an astrologer. Why wasn't the astrologer able to predict Mr. Khanna's future? The astrologer didn't have Mr. Khanna's horoscope, so he was not able to predict his future. Third question. In the conversation given above, who do you think has better common sense? The answer is, in the above conversation, I think that the astrologer has a better common sense. Task 2. My brother, an army doctor, was part of the UN peacekeeping mission in the Congo. At the end of 1 year, taken his condolence, commander awarded him a letter of merit that ended with dash, and he worked hard to restore normalcy to the region. Which word in the passage above gives the opposite meaning of what was meant to be said? The word in the passage above which gives the opposite meaning is hardly. It is written dash, and he worked hard to restore normalcy to the region. Hardly. Here gives the meaning that the army doctor almost not worked to restore normally in the region. The correct word, therefore, should be hard, which means a great deal of effort. The correct sentence, therefore, is dash, and he worked hard to restore normalcy to the region. Task 3. Look at the cartoon. Interpret it orally with your partner. What is funny as shown in the cartoon? A man is seen entering the lift. He appears tired and sleepy. Instead of pressing the floor button on the lift's console, he is seen pressing the lift's console. He is seen pressing the lift man's coat button. Learn grammar through communication. Use of models. Some sentences are given below. Rewrite them beginning with the clue given in the brackets. B. Identify the language function. One example is given. Example. Is it all right if I sit here? Begin with could dash function. Seeking permission. Sentences rewritten. Could I sit here? First one. Please return my library books. Begin with will. Function request. Second one. The files are heavy. I'll carry them for you. Begin with would. Function seeking permission. Third one. That's your essay. Perhaps you have no objection if I see it. Begin with may. Function seeking permission. Let me switch on the fan. Okay. Begin with do you. Function seeking permission. Fifth one. Bring the books to my office. Begin with would. Function order. The answer is, will you return my library books? Second one, would you let me carry the files for you? May I see your essay? Fourth one, do you want me to switch on the fan? Fifth one, would you bring the books to my office? Task 3. With the help of a dictionary, find out what you can understand about the following words. Number 1. Check and C-H-E-C-Q-U-E and C-H-E-C-K as nouns. C-H-E-Q-U-E, check. A written order to a bank to pay money from a bank account to another person. Check. A sudden stop. A restraint, a test of correctness or accuracy, a square, example, on a drought board, a pattern of squares, check in and check out, to record the arrival and departure. Second one, hire and rent as verbs, hire, to give or get the use of by paying money, rent, to pay rent for things, house building, shop, etc. So this is the end of the notes given from the textbook for the chapter A Hero.
Hit the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get instant updates of the video that we post.